And Rise. So you were sitting, you were front and center. You were just in front of your camera, ready for the interview. Congratulations. How do you feel?
Thank you, Paco.
I want to talk about this matchup against Secret. So Secret's been having a pretty bad week overall, you know, not with just the qualifiers, but now also Pro League. You got to see what they brought against G2. They were running all over the map. They were peaking everything. But that really didn't look like the Secret today. Were you anticipating aggressiveness on their part, or were you expecting more restraint, like what they played on both attack and defense?
Well, the thing is, I think Secret managed to win against G2 because like G2 was in a bad day, to be honest. At this point, I think like we just know how to play against Secret now, because Leon Games is like playing around most of the time as a roamer, and it's like really easy to counter it, to be honest. So yeah, we just focus on the roamers, and then we manage to do proper executions. That's the kind of attacks we use against them at the moment.
Now, you have a pretty important matchup coming up in the next 72 hours for a spot to go to Montreal. A lot of people have been suggesting that some of the reason why some teams are not performing as well as they usually do is because they are, quote-unquote, saving their strategies for Invitational. As a team who needs to bust out their strategies, ensuring your spot at the Invitationals, how much of that do you think is complete and utter nonsense, and how much validity do you think there actually is to that argument?
What do you mean? Like
in terms of hiding your strategies so that you don't reveal everything and you try to save them for when you need them the most.
Well, to be honest, we use 100% of our strategies because, yeah, six Invitational is a lot to us. So we really want to go to the six. But the thing is, and I think it's one of our strengths, is like we constantly like change our way to play the attacks. And for the defense, it doesn't really matter because you can just adapt on some point against some teams, and it still works. For example, our defense and consulate is the same. We used with the Millennium like for a year now, and it's still working. The lobby one I'm talking about, it's a really aggressive setup, and it's still working 1 year after. It's like one of our strongest defense, actually. So I think even if we use our strategies like to 100% either in a six Invitational qualifier or in Pro League, like we are still not really expected in game.
Right. Last question. It's a super quick one. How is the team and roster feeling as you've had now a couple months to actually get to know the rest of the team? Because you're performing really well, you're beating good opponents, but how do you as a team member feel about this, and where do you feel you've made the most improvements as a team?
I think the best improvement we've made as a team is like the coordination, definitely, because the first game of Pro League we did against us was like everything but that. So yeah, I think we managed to have like a good coordination between the Droners and the Fraggers. And I think the team is like really happy about the results, obviously. And I'm the first one to be happy because I finally can see improvements when you actually talk about problems you have in scrims and the next day it's still the same thing. It's kind of frustrating. So we don't have this anymore in this team, and I think it's feels good. Really feels good.
Well, congratulations on your victory today. Pass that along to the rest of the team who you're surrounded by, and bon chance in the actual qualifiers as well. You've got a 1-in-3 shot of making it to Montreal, so good luck, as I said, and anything to say to your fans, the org, the sponsors, the viewers, etc., before we go?
Thank you very much, and again, thank you very much for the amazing support. It's really appreciated.
Absolutely. Take care and enjoy the rest of your day.
Thank you.
Thanks. Well spoken. Good to see this team realizing its potential, and they're not out of the woods yet. They've still got a much bigger and more ambitious goal, which is either beat Empire or beat Vitality in order to secure their spot in Montreal. Here are the standings for you.